The importance of small business for the continuing growth of market economies can not be underestimated. However, the tools for helping these millions of business owners for years seemed out of reach. After all, which small business owner could afford to hire a consultant from McKinsey or Bain? So can a small or medium-sized business get world-class business help and advice from different kind of business development professional? Well, just as world-class athletes strive to get better by working with the top performers and coaches in their respective fields, more business owners than ever are looking to improve their game through coaching. But what is the difference between a consultant and a business coach? Well, there is a couple of dimensions to this. For me, it's a little bit like the biblical parable, give a man a fish, you feed him for a day, teach a man to fish, you feed him for a lifetime. So the consultant is more like the former than the latter. In other words, the consultant is there to pretty much set the tone, set the direction, offer the advice, service, or whatever it is that you need him or her to do. They tell the client what and how to do it, whereas the role of the coach is not to actually deliver product, but rather to help the client, in my case the business owner, to figure out the answer that is right for them. That's mostly done through asking the right questions, helping the client to reframe or look at the problem from different perspectives and provide feedback. This is known as the Socratic method of teaching. Socrates had the idea that we don't actually teach something to someone. What we do is help them figure it out for themselves. Now, some people take the view that the whole idea of the Socratic method and helping a client work out an answer that's right for themselves is a bit soft and fluffy. For sure, one part of that I do agree with is that if it comes down to using a particular system, tool, or strategy, and that's new to the business owner, then yeah, you can kind of operate in the mode of consultant, or you offer a tool or some kind of strategy that is going to help that business owner. But at the end of the day, whether the owner decides to take that tool forward or use that or implement that strategy is up to the owner, and the role of the coach is then to help them figure out that answer based on their values, their goals, and what they deem right for them. The role of a coach is to more to help the client stay accountable for the things that they've chosen or what they want to be held accountable for. And so that's the big distinction. The other feature of coaching is to have your client or coachee to come up with their own answer, because when it's their answer, they are more likely to own it and implement it. In that way, they're much more likely than to do whatever is necessary to make it happen and to take it forward. So as a consultant, you're kind of in the you should business, you should do this, you should do that. That's the very opposite of coaching. However, what I would say is that it's never that pure. It's never you're purely in the role of coach. Sometimes we're there as a bit of a counselor, sometimes we're there as a bit of a teacher, and sometimes we're there as an advisor. But the ultimate place where I spend most of my time, or the ultimate principle that I deem to be the foundation of coaching, is the idea of that Socratic method. As a coach, I'm going to help a client stay accountable for the results that they want to be held accountable for, and my role as a coach is to help them figure out what they want to be held accountable for. So the difference between a consultant and a coach is perspective and the way in which you perceive or the way in which you position the person you are working with. Even though many owners are armed with information defining the differences between a coach and a consultant, the decision to hire a coach or a consultant may still involve an element of risk, and many owners may opt for a consultant by default. While that's not surprising, given that business consulting is better known as a category, owners looking for more than a quick fix are more likely to turn to coaching for help. With a more generalized approach, marked by benchmarks and accountability, the decision for many owners when they have the option is easy. They choose a business coach. Why? Because without the level of accountability that business coaching offers, lasting change in the business is fleeting, and all the strategies and methodologies in the world are ultimately useless if an owner isn't held accountable to put those changes into place. And while very few consultants will hold an owner accountable to achieving goals, objectives, or results, very good business coaches always hold their clients accountable. So, are you ready for business coaching? As an owner, you have to ask yourself if you're coachable, or at least willing to be coached. That means admitting you don't know everything. It also means being willing to implement new and sometimes uncomfortable ideas for you and your company. You also need to be willing to do the work necessary to grow the company. Why? Because unlike a consultant who may do a project and leave, your business coach will educate you on strategy and process and leave it to you to implement. So your coach won't do the work, but will expect the work to get done. So for the coaching process, that's where accountability comes in and is key to your achievement and your company's ultimate success. If you have any questions on this, book a complimentary 15-minute call with me at timewithshane.com. In those 15 minutes, we'll find out if you are good to go on your own or if you could use some help. I'm Shane Spears of Summit Scale. See you next time.